afternoon. This is your captain speaking with just a little flight information. Coming up on the left, we're going to be catching a glimpse of the Grand Canyon. On the right, you can be able to see the Hoover Dam in just a few minutes. We're flying at an altitude of 37,000 feet, and our airspeed is 400 miles an hour. Couple little facts here. I'm packing a Colt King Cobra. That's a 357 caliber firearm with a black rubber grip and a 6-inch barrel. Also, the co-pilot is carrying a Kimber custom defense pistol with all the bells and whistles you'd expect from a custom gun of that kind, with an alloy frame and bevel treatment on the entire gun. And our chief flight attendant, Roger, has a Ruger Bearcat 22 with a hand-fluted cylinder. All three are capable of piercing body armor at a distance of up to 27 feet. And it can put a hole in human bone and flesh the size of the Grand Canyon, which, by the way, is coming up on the left-hand side of the plane. So just sit back and relax and enjoy the rest of the flight. We'll be right back.
Welcome to R2 Network Services. Helen speaking. Can I take your name, please?
Yeah, good afternoon, Helen. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
John Jenkins, Click Controls. All right, from Dyson. Companion going to school with, typical Friday. Mm-hmm. Have you the network pass with Albatross?
It is, thank
just
you.
Voicemail reset on the following number.
Yep.
077. 989. 989. Have you been very busy, or?
Yeah, strange because we've got a congestion with text messages at the moment.
I'm joking,
so we're
I heard about
really
that.
Busy at the moment.
You're not going to get paid double for it, though.
Unfortunately, not. Just hold line for me one moment.
Cheers.
Thanks.
You are at the O2 voicemail main menu.
Okay, thanks for holding again. That's been reset and it's working for you.
Bye, mate. Have a good room. Give me one more. Then,
did you ever commission the hacking of voicemails? You know, I can't believe you asked me that question, to be honest. I mean, you know, I think I've made my position extremely clear on my innocence.
Hello? Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah,
hello, it's Glenn.
Hello,
mate. Just a very quick one. Voicemail reset on Gordon Taylor, and it's got Tottenham-related issues on there.
Great. Same number.
Same number. Do not delete anything. Yeah, you got the number, haven't you?
Can you just give me...
What, you just put his own phone number in again?
Correct, yeah.
And what's the main number again for your interrupt?
Yeah, you need to dial 7973.
7973.
100.
Sorry, 100.
123.
100123.
Correct. You put his number in.
Yeah.
It asks you for the pin, then put his number back in.
Yeah.
And there's three messages on there from Tottenham, right?
Fantastic. Thank
all right.
Thank
all right, cheers. Give me a text message where it works, yeah?
Yeah, we'll do.
All right, bye.
Welcome to the O2 messaging service. Please enter your pin, followed by the hash key.
What's happened?
My friend and I got into an altercation. And I'm the only one who came out alive.
Are you telling me you killed somebody?
Yes, I am.
Right, and who am I speaking to?
My name is Lewis Gaines, I'm 18 years old, and I live at 12 Greyland, Rosebury Road. Grey, that's it, Birmingham, Mike 175.
Right, okay. And what's actually happened?
My friend came to stay the night with me yesterday. Feeling very down, feeling suicidal, and I woke up this morning, he was in a mess, so I tried to calm him down, I hugged him, then said that I was there for him. He shrugged me off.
Can you just bear with me a second, don't tell me any more, okay? You're telling me he's definitely dead?
Yes, I'm telling you, he's definitely dead.
Tell me a second. Right, okay, Lewis, I need you to just take me back through that again. So what happened last night?
Okay. He came to stay with me because he was feeling down. I tried.
What's his name?
Brett. B-R-E-C-K. Bednar. B-E-D-N-E.
Sorry, B-R-E...
C-K.
Brett.
Yeah.
And then his surname is?
Bednar, B-E-D-N-E-R.
Okay, so he came to stay with you.
I can explain this to the officers.
I need to take these initial details.
I know. He came to stay with me the night. I did my best to comfort him. I woke up this morning. He was in a mess. I tried again.
Right, just slow down again, Lewis. I need to take these details. So did you have an argument with him last night?
No, we were fine.
You were fighting?
No, we were fine. We were fine last night. We both went to sleep. I said...
Come on. Loretta had two children for the sole purpose of sexual assault and rape. Jonathan, as Loretta was told by his girlfriend Sarah when she was pregnant, that she was expecting a baby girl, and he said that the only way that he would marry her is if she agreed to allow him to rape this little girl continuously for as long as he wanted. Now, Sarah and Loretta is such a sad, pathetic human being that she agreed to this so-called parenting plan, and she had the little girl, and she married him. Not long after she had the little girl, they also had a little boy. Now, Jonathan and Loretta carried out his plan. He raped this little girl repeatedly. He also sexually assaulted this little boy. And later, they ended up getting a divorce. Jonathan filed for divorce.
He filed for divorce. She's the sorriest person I've ever heard of.
She is the sorriest person I've ever heard of. And so they've both been tried, and they've both been found guilty. She pled guilty to 2 counts of sexual exploitation, and she faces up to 30 years in prison as a result of that. He faces life in prison. In fact, 10 years to life in prison. Hopefully, he will get a lengthy sentence, because after he got a divorce, he started dating someone else who also had a daughter, and he proceeded to rape that girl as well. And by the way, the new girlfriend, knew about it. She allowed it to happen, which means that there are 2 sorry-ass women in this story.
Yeah. Now, look, the guy is profoundly sick. He said the only reason he was interested in doing any of this is because he really wanted daddy-daughter sex with parents.
It's disgusting.
And, I mean, to create a child to have... When you first said this is the most vile story we've ever covered, and in the production meeting, I was like, come on. We've covered some terrible stories, but this really takes the cake. And for this sorry, sorry woman to say, well, she explained, I really wanted to be with her.
I know. I don't know where that desperation comes from. I don't know if it's because she was already pregnant, and you know, many reports do indicate that she was financially dependent on him, but I don't even care about that. I mean, there's no reason. You know, there's no reason that you would allow anyone to harm your own children like that, or any children at all. And I should know that he was awarded a Purple Heart in the Marines, and he was a high-ranking officer in the Marines. So, you know, he was highly respected. No one in his family or none of his friends expected him to do something like this. But you never know. There are monsters among us.
My name is Bruno, and to some, I'm everything and more, and to others, I'm nothing at all. You know, I'm at turns, according to those in the know. I'm honest, I'm caring, I'm generous, I'm horny, I'm loyal, I'm comfortable, I'm confident, yet at the same time, I'm shy, I'm cute, and I'm lively. I'm also a loving person, I'm beautiful, I'm forthright, I'm sensitive, I'm reliable, I'm tenacious, I'm vibrant, I'm profound, I'm sexy, I'm complicated, I can be sassy, I'm They say that I have the best desk below 14th Street. You know that. Is it true? Is it true? It's for you to make up your mind what I am to you. But from me, you can expect an absolute honesty, sometimes brutal.
Unicórnios que caem com a raiz não voltam mais. Ainda que Van Goghs, até que engasgues, sigo mula a indiciar o caso excepcional do sem espécie. Céu. Archived Mew. Exílio dos catálogos a especificar o espaço para a porcentagem da escolha do puro. Alheia que se agita antes de abrir. Dose cavalar de juramento e equidade. Me poupai, longe de mim impor me híbrida a tua hípica, brutalmente homogênea, especialista em fronteiras. Eject de habitat. Eis-me, excelentíssimo, a de cascos não retornáveis. Relinchando o já morto, muslos de molícia, esterilizável, aureolar, multivaga, ambiquestre de mulas prontas, perdoai vossa serva. Dáctila aos berros, perturbando vosso auro piquenique do sublime. E list, espirrando em vosso épico. Não há Blade Runner que resista. Mesmo meuzinho fake mula, inciente dos teus métodos, oh sussurrável ruf muffler da palha de meu estofo, prometo-me estoica e subcutânea, bem fazes em esporear-me o couro catecúmeno à chuva do teu corpo, inestimável senhor de eco entumecido, até que a mula que fale como manda o figurino encontre a exit de quem as caras me dera lamber o mundo com a própria língua. Mundo com a função.
Are you still with me?
Quero com o diabo. O Grêmio já show de lote. Todos nós brasileiros precisamos é do diabo. A saída é a linha do mal. Cosete-nos a radiação especial do nosso poderosíssimo amigo Cabral Batão.
Thank you. mascarado que não respeita a mulher nem a propriedade de ninguém. O meu fraco é mortadela. Ninguém sabe realmente a nacionalidade, muito menos a identidade desse jovem criminoso. Subdesenvolvido, brasileiro, cubano, mexicano, favelado, português. Quem tiver de sapato não sobra. O motorista poderá sobreviver, mas caolho. A Amazônia também é Brasil. E o petróleo é nosso. O petróleo é nosso. Tentei me matar com tinta óleo, mas não deu pé. Agora eu vou ficar com a tua mulher e nem um pio, nem um pio. Saí de lá faz 15 anos, da favela do Tatuapé pro mundo. Eu tinha que avacalhar, um cara assim só podia avacalhar. Eles me chamam de pistoleiro, mas eu não sou ladrão, eu não sou ladrão. O terceiro mundo vai explodir, quem tiver de sapato não sobra. Minha mãe tentou me abortar pra não morrer de fome. É preciso pecar em dobro, e quem tiver de sapato não sobra. É que a Amazônia também é Brasil. Sozinho, ninguém vale nada. Sozinho, ninguém vale nada. Essa é a verdadeira história de um homem que bebia uma garrafa de uísque estrangeiro por dia. Inventor do macete pra ganhar no bicho, inventor do método do violão mágico por correspondência. A terceira guerra já começou e ninguém tá dando bola. 5 minutos de leite de coco, muito leite de coco. Quando a gente não pode fazer nada, a gente avacalha. Um cara assim só podia avacalhar. Você faz o quê, minha filha? Curto-circuito na favela do Tatuapé. O motorista poderá sobreviver, mas caolho. Agora eu vou ficar com a tua mulher e nem um pio, nem um pio. É preciso pecar em dor. É preciso pecar em dor. O terceiro mundo vai explodir. Quem tiver de sapato não sobra. Traz uísque pra todo mundo que o rei da boca paga. Viva a pobreza! Viva a pobreza! Meu verdadeiro sonho era formar os Estados Unidos da América. Sozinho ninguém vale nada. O negócio é ser grosso. Taco fogo e me mando pra Acapulco, México. Vigia tem que morrer. Quem ganha 80 contos pra guardar 80 milhões tem que morrer. Não existe! É preciso pecar em dobro. É preciso pecar em dobro. É preciso pecar em dobro. Que miséria, meu filho, que miséria. Curto-circuito na favela do Tatuapé. Um país sem miséria, um país sem folclore. Glória, país sem turistas. A união faz a força. Traz o uísque pra todo mundo. Sozinho ninguém vale nada. E daí?